All right. Good morning, everyone. Thank you. So what I wanted to walk through today is essentially my workflow for social media. I get it done in about 15 minutes. Now, it's a system, right? I am posting everywhere. I don't recommend, I clearly have mental problems. I don't recommend that you post everywhere. Right now, I'm on every platform. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, Pinterest, Google My Business, YouTube, TikTok, and even Threads. Threads is the new Twitter that Facebook came out with. So I just enjoy social media, and that's a big part of why I'm everywhere, because I actually enjoy it. I don't recommend that. I think that you should, unless you want to, go for it. But I recommend that you stick to at least two. And if you can fit a third one in there, do it. Now, the worst thing you can do, though, is have accounts everywhere and not use it, because the last thing you want to do is have someone go to your Twitter and there's no content on there. And what's the impression? It's that you're not working, you're not busy, right? So only commit to what you're going to use. So just some statistics, and this is all NAR numbers, is that 38% of all business for realtors have come from social media. 38%. This is 2022 numbers. Now, I think that's going to change. I think that's always going to go up as time goes, just because we're all switching to digital presence. So as of 2022, 38% of business came from social media for realtors. Another interesting statistic is that the lead conversion rate on social media is between 0.4 and 1.2. So let's just say one. Let's pick a number in the middle, one. Essentially, that means that one in every 100 followers that you have will eventually, if you use social media optimally, should convert into business. So for one in every 100. And then in terms of the most popular social media sites, right, where business is coming from, Facebook, 53%. Okay. Instagram, 26%. And LinkedIn is 11%. So remember I said, try and stick to two or three, have those three be your top. If you only want to commit to three, have those three be your top. And obviously that's personal. For me, I get more business from Instagram than Facebook, but these are just NAR numbers. Okay. So I'm going to walk you through my workflow. It takes me 15 minutes, but because this is a training, it's going to be longer, because I'm going to be answering questions. I'm going to be talking out loud. Okay. So it'll probably take maybe like a half hour. But just know that if it wasn't for the questions and if it was just for me working, it's actually a little bit less than 15 minutes. 15 minutes is just a conservative number. I can probably get it done in like 11, 12 minutes. I use a little productivity timer here, and I do this on purpose so that I don't get distracted and I just get it done. Anything that you can do, if you can do it in 15 minutes, you can do it every day. So for me, I post two things, okay, every day, Monday through Saturday. Sunday, I take a break. The first thing I post is a real estate related article, and I'm going to show you how to post this across all platforms, okay? Because what do realtors do? It's always under contract, sold, new listing, open house. Okay, that's great if you're trying to attract other realtors. But remember that your buyer, your seller is selling every 5 to 8 years. They don't care. They only care when they're ready. And so how do you keep them engaged those other 4 or 5 years, right? You have to give them different types of value. So it can't always just be listings under contract, under contract, under contract, under contract. You have to give them value outside of that. So I post two posts every day as a minimum. And what I do is I post a real estate related article. Okay. And then what I do is then I post a listing. And then those are the two base. That's the base. Okay. And then you have to supplement with that. You have to supplement with who you are. So for me, there's a couple of things that define me. And so what I post, 25% of it is real estate. That's the article and the listing, right? Whatever that listing might be. It could be a new listing. It could be something I went under contract for. What you guys know how to do already, right? That's 25% of it. Another thing that defines me, Gigi, is food. So I'm constantly posting food. I love to eat. I love restaurants. My son, soccer, My two dogs, I have a mini schnauzer and a Frenchie, and those are very common dogs. So it's instant relatability. I love interior design and art. So I'm constantly posting things like that. And then non-cheesy quotes. So I'll do that. I know we're always posting quotes, but I try and really like post something that I haven't heard before. I try. So that makes up 100% of what I post. So what I'm going to show you today are the 25% in terms of real estate. Only you know what the other 75% are. Okay, but it's important to incorporate that because that's how you keep everyone engaged and you build rapport and you build trust and you build like, right? This know you, like you, trust you business. So I'm first going to open up the pages that I post to. So I will open up my Facebook business page. Facebook business page. This is what I do first. Facebook business page. I'll open up my LinkedIn. I'll open up my Twitter. Oh, I should have been logged in here. But so see, this buys time. But usually I'm logged into all of my devices already. All of my, so it's just a quick open. I'll open Pinterest and I'll open Google My Business. Okay, so I just open them up across the stream and then I start posting. Now, the real estate related article, there's two ways to do this. Okay, so what I do is I subscribe to the Florida Realtor News. Okay, so every morning I get these articles in my inbox and I'll pick one. All right, you can go to here, Florida Realtor News here, and you can just bookmark the page. All right. So right here, this is it. And there's some pretty good content on here. Okay. It's very basic. And every day they have like 5 to 8 new articles and I'll share something from here. Okay. Now, important, try and stay positive. Okay. Because like, let's say you're a buyer's agent or you're trying to attract a buyer for whatever reason, you know, that's just your thing. I'm more of a listing agent, but even though, you know, I'll still help a couple buyers here and there. So for example, this is a good one to post. Mortgage rates retreat, drop to 7.18. Sorry, my dog is like breathing heavy. Try and avoid, you know, buyer confidence low, or, you know, mortgage rates shoot up to 9%, you know, like, or anything like that, because that's just, it's accurate. You know, and maybe you want to be more accurate than anything, but if there's a positive article here, try and do that. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll open up the article and I will share this across all my feeds. Okay. So I'll just copy the URL at the top, copy. Now, here we go. We'll go to Facebook. Let me switch to my page here. Okay. And then I will just post. Now it'll load an image here. And what I do is I remove the link at the top. I remove the link. It keeps the link. And then what I do is I get the highlighted part right up here. The summary, I post it. You see it here. So it adds some engagement. It's not so cold. And then I will add 2 hashtags. And I will add the hashtag about what the article is about. So one thing I see realtors do all the time is that they'll put Miami Realtor, Miami Real Estate. And they'll do that for all of their posts. No, be a little bit. Relate yourself to what you're writing. So for something like this, I would write mortgage rates. And then I would put interest rates, something like that. Okay. And that's it. Now, what I would do is I would copy this that I wrote up here. Copy. Okay. Let me see. I'll answer all these questions in a bit. And then now I'm going to post all of this. Let me post it. Post. All right. Facebook is done. All right. Now let's open up LinkedIn. Let me post the link. Let it load. There it is. Let me delete the link. Let me post the summary. Here it is. Post. LinkedIn is done. Let's go to Twitter. Twitter. Paste the link. Here's the summary. And then let me paste the link here. There we go. Post. Twitter's done. Pinterest. Create. Create a pin. Add the title. So what's the title here? Mortgage rates retreat right here. Boom. Now I want to add a photo. I'll use the same photo. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to save the image to my desktop. Desktop save. And I'm going to upload it here. There it is. Now I'll fill in the description right here. That little summary, right? I'll keep the hashtags. Destination link is the link to the article. Publish. Pinterest is done. And I'll do the same thing for Google My Business. So here it is. I'm going to add a post here. Add the description. Copy paste it, right? I'll put learn more. You have different buttons. I'll always put learn more. I'll add the link. And then that image that I saved, I'll grab it from my desktop. And Google My Business is done. Okay. So that was done in what, 3.5 minutes? And that's the real estate related article. Now I also post a listing across all platforms. Okay. And I'm going to show you that next. Let me just answer some questions here. Which one do you feel is best effective? Facebook backend is limited to only Facebook socials though. Lauren, what do you mean by that? It's Facebook socials. Let me know what you mean.
Okay, there's a question above that. So I was asking you, so I know like certain platforms, you're able to post on all your social medias at one time. I play around with a bunch of different like platforms and stuff like that. And then I noticed that Facebook actually has its own backend to post to like, you know, their platform all at once. But for me, I just wanted to know which one have you found the most effective for you? Because,
I don't use them.
Okay, because I know I was using Hoot Suite at one point, but then like you get to having to like pay these monthly fees, and I'm like, okay,
all I do is I just open up all my tabs and I copy paste. I don't use those programs. Okay. Number one, because it's money. I rather put that money somewhere else. Exactly. Number two, it's more effective in terms of productivity, but it's less personal. You're just hitting one button. Here, you can at least engage. You can see if someone commented. You can comment back. You can, you know, you're more hands-on. And a big part of social media is that you're personal. And if you're using another software and you're just posting something and hitting send, you're not really engaging with the platform. So you have to decide what's best for you, but I won't pay Hootsuite, whatever their monthly is, $20, $30, I don't know. But I rather put that in like an IDX site, for example, which will leverage me a little bit better. So, and as you saw, it took me 3 minutes.
Can you say that site again? I'm sorry.
Hootsuite?
No, not Hootsuite. You said you'd rather put the money to where?
In an IDX website, which I'll show you now. Yeah, okay. Which is going to leverage me more. Okay, so let me see if it's for planning in advance. Correct. So that's another option. But however, some news is in the moment. So let's say you plan your month, but something happened. You might be outdated, right? So for me, I rather post what's in the moment. That way I stay relevant. So that's what I do. And that's why I go to the Florida Realtor News, because every day they're adding something that's pertaining to that day. And so I'm in the moment. You know, if I post this, let's say I post this and I post it in 2 weeks, I program it to post it in 2 weeks. Well, it's kind of outdated now because in 2 weeks, interest rates might be different, right? Okay, let me see. All right, great. Okay, now the next thing I'll post is a listing. Okay, so I'll keep the windows open, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Pinterest, Google My Business. I'll leave the pages open. Now the listing, this I have an IDX website for, but I'm going to give you a solution. Remember that the brokerage has Chime now. Chime, for an extra $30, will give you an IDX site. Okay. Now you're going to have to, it's a template. You're right. You're doing daily news. Your system is daily. Correct. This is my IDX website. It's $59 for me. And I use dpishowcase.com. It's actually a company that I help manage. And what I do is I post a listing every day. And the benefit of an IDX website is that you can go to any property. Let's search single family. I don't know. Let's just pick a random one. I like posting ones with nice pictures because remember, social media platforms are image based. It's all about visual. So I can post any listing as long as you have the IDX website or post from an IDX site. You can post any listing without permission. The permission is the IDX, if that makes sense. So let's go ahead and do this one right here. You guys can still hear me, but my screen is going in and out.
You're kind of choppy. You're like glitching on our end.
Okay, give me a second. Let it refresh itself here. Okay, I think I still might be glitchy. So, give me a moment. Sometimes Zoom does this. One moment. Okay, I think I'm back up.
Hello? It sounds like you're going faster is what it was. Try again, Gigi.
Okay, I think we're good.
That's it.
I think I'm back up. It's not glitchy anymore for me. Okay, so I was just picking a listing, okay? So here, this picture works. Okay, and I can share any listing. So I'll go up here, and I'll go to copy the URL, and I'll just post it. So here we go. Facebook, right? And what I'll do is, remember, I delete the link. I want to make it more personal. And the way that I do it is I will pick the area that this is in. So I'll just do Kendall. I'll put the price, $599. Okay. I will post bedrooms and bathrooms, 4 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms. I'll put the square footage, 16.7 square feet. And then visually, I can see it has a garage. And I will just go backwards and I'll see if it has a pool. No pool. And then I'll post it just like that. Now, the hashtags for the listing, I will keep it local. So if this is a Kendall listing, I'll put Kendall Realtor, Kendall Real Estate. And I'll alternate the cities based on where I service. So I service everywhere from Homestead up to Doral. So there's like 5 or 6, 7 cities within that chunk of area. So I'll do Kendall today. I'll do Cutler Bay tomorrow. I'll do Palmetto Bay the next day. So I'll pick a listing from that. So let's copy the description here. Copy. And now we're going to post it on all the other platforms. Okay. Post. So you can see here on my feed, on my Facebook feed, that I have a real estate related article here and a listing up here. Now let's do LinkedIn. So I'm going to copy the link on LinkedIn. Wait, the link first. Let the preview load. Give it a second. There it is. Let me delete. And post. LinkedIn is done. Facebook and LinkedIn are done. Let's go to Twitter. Again. And then the link. Post. Twitter is done. Okay. Let's go to Pinterest. So let's create a new pin. The title is that description. Again, I'll just put the description again. The destination link is the link to the listing on your IDX website. And now it does require an image. So what I'll do is I will do a quick save here on the image. I'll save this. I'll save it to my desktop again. And then I just upload it here.
Gigi, have you seen a turnaround from Pinterest, or do you have it more just to have that additional social media advertisement?
What I've seen is a lot of traffic from Pinterest to my website. That's what I've seen. So it's not direct business. I have not gotten direct business from Pinterest. And remember that in terms of your website, whether you have it or not, if you don't have it, I recommend, sign up with Chime with the brokerage. And you can, add that extra $30 for a website with Chime. And Chime will include the IDX. You'll have all the listings on your website for $30. Mind you, you have to set up your website on your own. But what will rank
you're choppy high... again.
Hello. You hear me? You guys hear me?
No.
Okay. Hang on. I don't know why. Yeah, I see it glitchy on my end. What about now?
No.
No? Okay, give me a moment. One moment. All right, what about now?
It's a little better.
Okay. Yeah, it's happening like every 5 minutes. It's like a glitch.
No, it's still choppy. It's still choppy. Okay. Yeah.
Okay, hang on. Okay.
Now you're good. Now you're good.
Now you're good. Yeah.
Okay. So remember that what ranks you high on Google is how many backlinks you have to your website. How many other sites are pointing to your website? So this whole Pinterest and me being on all the social medias is does a couple things. Number one, it brings people back to my website. All right. I get a lot of visits from Pinterest to my website. In my analytics, I see it. And they count as backlinks. So that's mainly what it's for. And you never know. You never know when someone is going to go to Pinterest and they do end up, you know, hiring you. Now, another thing, being everywhere validates me at the listing appointment. So sometimes I'll get there and we will jump into that conversation of exposure, and I will get that often. I will get it. Oh yeah, no, you're everywhere. Yeah. I know. So it might not be direct business initially for you, but it's definitely validation, backlinks to your website, and also just being active on the platform. The last thing you want to do is fall behind on a platform that ends up exploding later. Right. You can't post articles to Instagram.
Me nunca me
Let me mute
everyone. Y yo muy feliz con mi niña. Y mi mamá, se ponía que chillaba.
Mute
ella quería era un niño. Pues téngalo usted porque no lo tuvo. Y entonces mis hijas todas tienen, mis dos hijas tienen.
I'm hitting mute all. Can you mute yourself, whoever's speaking? Okay. So you cannot post. You cannot post articles to LinkedIn. You're right. The post, the actual post does not allow links in the caption. However, you can take a screenshot. You can go to this. You can go to this article on your phone. Think about this for a second. You can go to this article on your phone. Take a screenshot on your phone. It's already formatted in a mobile presentation. Take a screenshot. Go to your stories, post that screenshot to your stories, and then get the link widget and link it to this article. That's my workaround for Instagram. Okay. So we did Pinterest, and then I would do the same thing for Google My Business. All right. I would add the description of the property, learn more, the link to the IDX site, the listing on the IDX site. In that photo, I'll upload the one that I downloaded right here. Boom. Post. So we posted real estate related article and a listing, and we did it on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Pinterest, Google My Business. Okay. Quickly. Now Instagram, I go back to Instagram and I do what I told you. I'll visit my Facebook page on Instagram. I'll go to the article. I'll take a screenshot. I'll post it on my stories with a link to the article. I'll go to the listing here on my phone. I'll take a screenshot of it. I'll post it to my stories with the link widget back to this listing. And so that's my content on Instagram. So, are there any questions about that? Now, the IDX site. So IDX site is monthly. It's $30 a month with Chime. $30 is still a great price. The only thing, the only downside to that is that it's a template. You're clicking and dragging and you're essentially designing your own website yourself. So if you have a little bit of a design background, if you have a little bit of time to do it, go for it. If not, you can look into dpishowcase.com, which is this company that I use, that I also manage. And for $59, you can, they'll give you something exactly like this. All you have to do is give them your picture and your contact information, and they'll deliver exactly this to your website, to yourself. And you can use this as a writing site. Now, the good thing about Showcase is that they're writing articles for you. So if you go, I think I'm gonna glitch again. Let me know.
We're losing you again.
Yeah. Let's wait. 5 seconds. Let's wait. Let me know when I'm back up. Testing. Sound again. Yep.
Okay. Better.
Okay, now I'm back.
You're back.
Yeah, it's like every 5 minutes it'll do this little. I'm not sure why. I don't get any alerts on my end. So let's see. Let me answer some questions. So the IDX site with Showcase, for example, the 59 includes content on your blog. So if I were to go to blog here, you'll see that they're writing articles for you. That's part of your $59. And you can share these, right? You can just come here. You can copy the URL at the top and you can paste that everywhere. And that's an opportunity to bring people back to your website instead of somewhere else, right? Because right now we're just finding articles somewhere. I like the Florida Realtors. You can go to NAR. NAR has great articles. You can go to The Real Deal Miami. That's another place for great articles. If you have a website with blog features where you can blog yourself or they're doing it for you, then you can just copy the blog from your website and it'll bring people back to your website. Not to mention the IDX, right? The IDX, you have the entire MLS on your website and you can share any listing that you want. And the good thing about that is that the listing agent's information is gone. Legally, we have to put the broker, right? Calvet Realty. But there's no phone number. There's nothing. And if any of this information were filled out, the lead goes to you, not the listing agent. So that's huge. I really don't use it for this. I just use it more for content to my social media. But if that's something you're interested in, just reach out to me privately and we can take it from there. But if not, remember to onboard yourself with Chime, with the brokerage, Lifestyle has it now, and pay that extra $30 a month. And that'll give you a site that you can use to leverage your social media. So let me ask some questions here. You post both at the same time once a day, or how many times are you posting? I post both once a day, Monday through Saturday, because it literally takes me less than 10 minutes to do. What is the 59 company? dpishowcase.com. So dpishowcase.com. It's this right here. Like I said, this is a project that my partner and I have been working on for 15 years. So reach out to me and I will give you something. If you choose to do that. However, it's $59, so $60. If you have it in you and you want to save that extra $30, do it through Chime. It's just, you know, it's going to be a little bit more work for you. Another good thing about a DPI site is that they have all the new projects in Miami. So if you go here to developments and you go to new developments, you can see all the content. So Another good example, you can share a project every day, a new project every day. It's pretty cool, right? So let me answer some questions here. Do you have time frames or do you just wing it when you want to post? I know algorithms based. No, I don't. Yes, there are. Every single social media platform has a different one. They'll say Tuesdays and Thursdays for Facebook. Twitter is like 3 a.m, which is crazy. I don't. I just, when I wake up, before my prospecting, I'll do my social media. If I can't get to my social media, I'll prospect and then do my social media. So it's once a day, every day. I don't really focus on time. I'm not looking to go viral. Okay. If it happens, great. But what I'm looking for is just providing valuable content every day to prospective clients. That's my goal. So some quick tips that I wanted to tell you guys is, you're posting to your Facebook business page, right? But remember, chances are you have a bigger following personally on your personal page. Like I do, for example, I only have like, I think 1,000 followers here on my business page because I just started it maybe like 8 months ago, but I have 4.9 followers on my actual personal page. So what I'll do is I will share that article and that listing from my business page over to my personal page. So I'll go to my business page here. Uh-oh, I might be going out again. I might be going out again. Just wait with me. Hang on. Just wait those 30 seconds. You guys hear me?
Try again, Gigi.
What about now?
Still sound a little.
What about now? Think about.
Still rough.
Okay. Hang on. Just let me know when I'm back up.
Now you're back.
Okay. So what I'll do is I'll post that article from my business page to my personal page. Okay. So I'll go to my business page here. Let it load. And then here it is. So I will go here to share and I will share to feed. And what I'll do is I'll include the original post right there. Share. And now this post, whatever it is I posted on my business, also to my personal. And that way I don't have anything falling through the cracks. You see here, this is my personal page. And now you can see here that I reposted. Okay. And then if they want to like my business page, they have access to it right here. And they can go here and like it.
We stuck on one page. We're stuck on the property details with the building.
Okay, hang on. Let me reshare. What about now?
No, ma'am. Same page.
I see both screens, Gigi. I don't know. Maybe it's...
Okay.
Okay. I was zoomed in. Sorry.
So that's a tip, right? Everything you post to your business page, share it to your personal page. That way you're hitting both target audiences. Not everyone that follows you on your business follows you personally. You might have your Facebook icon on a website or on your Linktree or somewhere else where someone goes there and likes your business page and they don't know anything about you personally. They're not a friend of yours, nothing. And vice versa. You might have a bunch of friends that just haven't liked your business page. So by you resharing to your personal page, what you post on your business does two things. Number one, it alerts those people. And number two, it gives them an opportunity to go back to your business page and like it. All right. So that's a tip. Another tip is that every time I'm on my LinkedIn and I'm posting, I'll make 10 new connections. That's just a checkbox. I'll go to my network here and I try and avoid realtors. Realtors are not going to give me business, right? So what I will do, I mean, maybe there's exceptions, right? But for the most part, I'll skip realtors and I'll usually go to the school I went to, the Art Institute. It has this little red eye. You guys can go wherever school you went to, if you're whatever, just not realtors. You can see here, and I'll just start making connections. I'll make a mental note to just do 10 of them. And that's it. That is like a checklist I do here on LinkedIn. That way I'm constantly building my LinkedIn database. I don't dig into it. I don't, who is this? I don't. I just connect, and I do that. I do 10 a day, and every time I'm posting to LinkedIn. That's a tip. Let me see. There's a bunch of chats. You're zoomed in. I see both. Da, 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 da. Definitely was reading and forgot. Okay. What another tip? No, that's it. What questions Gigi, do you
I got,
guys have?
I got questions for you.
Yeah.
I got questions for Dave. So the first one, you first spoke, you mentioned that you're a listing agent on social media. What are you putting out there that makes you get listings from your social media? Obviously I saw, you know, your listing ads, but are you speaking specifically to possible
no.
sellers or
so
what,
the
what,
way,
what are you saying?
No, the way I get listings is I prospect. I prospect 2 hours every day. I am now launching a huge buyer campaign where I'm going to start reaching out to buyers too. But I do not get listings from social media. I have gotten a few. They've been friends, people that, but it's not like I do through prospecting. You know, prospecting will give me 4 or 5 listings a month. And that is outbound prospecting, calling for sale by owners, expireds, absentees, old expireds. It's that. That's what gives me the majority of listings. Social media is there for just being top of mind and also validating. That's what it is for me, validating myself when I enter that listing appointment. Because, you know, a big part of at least the sellers that I interact with is exposure. You know, that's where this is going. It's not about really being a realtor anymore. You actually have to be an ad agency. So naturally, the more people know about something, the more it's going to sell for, naturally. And putting it up on the MLS and putting a post out in front of the house, not enough anymore. So it's mainly for that. And also because I would like to start incorporating more buyers, and you can really leverage social media with buyers as opposed to, you know, listing.
Okay. Your sound is glitchy again, but while you're fixing it, I'm going to ask you another question. Just a heads up. So I know you used Chime and Showcase. My fear with using websites those type of websites for my website is that what if I decide to leave them? Do I lose my website, or are you creating your own website name from like GoDaddy or something like that and then giving it to them for them to design? What are you doing?
Okay, are you hearing me? Can you guys hear me before
yes.
I go on this rant?
Yes.
Okay.
Great.
So always own your own domain. Always own your own domain. I recommend that. For example, Showcase, DPI Showcase, there are realtors that have no idea. They're like, what? Domain? And I'm like, don't worry, we'll purchase it for you. And then if they ever leave us, we will transfer that domain to them. That's us. However, not every company is that way, and I wouldn't trust anyone. So I would always own your own domain, buy it on GoDaddy. Actually, I recommend always buying your domains on Google, because Google gives you the SSL certificate for free. So right now, if you go to a domain, you see the little lock, that SSL will rank you higher, and Google gives that to you for free. GoDaddy, you have to spend an extra $80 a year to get that. So I always buy all my domains on GoDaddy. And then you, when they're done designing whatever it is that they need to design, they will point your domain to the website. And should you ever leave for whatever reason, then you just take, you know, you cancel the site, your domain is still yours and you can use it elsewhere. Same thing with a database, right? Like let's say Chime, for example, the brokerage has it. You can download your contacts. Should you ever want to leave Chime? Chime has a download CSV file. So I would download all my contacts before I cancel, and then I would import, and then I'd cancel Chime. So there's options. Any other questions before we get out of here? Because I know that it's already 9:15. This is recorded. Hopefully those glitches didn't record, but I think they did. I think we're good. Everyone good? Any other questions? So if you guys are interested in a dpishowcase.com website, just message me privately on WhatsApp, and we'll take it from there. If not, utilize Chime, okay? It's really good. Where can we see this again? I think George uploads it to the Lifestyle YouTube page. All right. Thanks, guys. Have a good day.
Thanks, Gigi.
Bye.